Hello and welcome back. We have learned till now how to navigate through our Excel database using the back and next buttons. We can clear the text boxes. Then we have learned how to add data without any duplicates via our user form into the database. Yesterday we learned how to update the data, and today I'm sure everybody is excited to learn about the search button. So let's go ahead and code the search button. Double click on the search button. We are brought to our Microsoft Visual Basic for Applications window. Here we have two lines of code. The first thing we will do is declare two variables. So dim dot rows, which stands for total rows, comma I as long, now we need to get the value of the total rows used in our Excel worksheet database. So we will get the value like this. Dot rows is assigned the value worksheets sheet 1 dot range A1 dot current region dot rows dot count. So this time we are using the current region property to get the total rows used in our database. Make sure that the data is contiguous and there are no blank rows. We will now loop through all our data. So for I, assign the value 2 to dot rows. If trim sheet 1 dot cells I comma 1 if that is assigned the value from trim text box 1 dot text then, and here I noticed that I forgot a bracket, so I'll put it here. Then we need to do a few things. We need to get the data from our worksheet into the user form for display. So text box 1 dot text will be assigned the value from sheet 1 dot cells I comma 1. Similarly, text box 2 will get its value from, let me put the whole path, so sheet 1 dot cells I comma 2, and text box 3 dot text we will get from sheet 1 dot cells I, 3. And once we get the data, we need to exit the loop. So it's not necessary to work further. Then we do the end if, and we started with a for loop, so we complete that by using next I. Now this is the very basic code that you need to search for data in your database by filling out the text box 1. So let's save this. Let's run this by clicking on the run button, and you know already that when the user form fires up, our global variable current row is set to 2, so we get this data from row 2 displayed in our user form. We can clear this data and we can look for a student, let's say Smith Butler, so you can see he is mentioned here in row number 7. So if I do search, I should get his grade and marks into my user form, and there it is. Now you can also clear this data and of course add Laura Summers and search for her data. So we say search, and we get her grade and marks. Now what happens if the user doesn't enter any name here and just says search? So we need to make a provision for that also. So I'm going to close this. We'll go back to our search button code, and right at the top after the declaration here, we will write if textbox 1.text, if the user leaves that blank, then we should give out a message. So message box, enter the name you wish to search. We could have also written, you cannot leave this text box 1 blank. So we have then end if. Now we save this. We click on the run button. If I clear this now and say search by mistake, it gives me a message, enter the name you wish to search. So that does our work. Now there is something very interesting that one can do. What happens if the name doesn't exist or the name is not found? We need to give out some message. This one is slightly dicey, but let's have a look. So I close this, double click on the search button, and inside the for loop we can have another condition, which means if. So since I'm going to write that, I can copy this here instead of writing it. So copy this here, Control V, and I have to write here two conditions. If the value from the text box is brought into the cell and that is not equal to that value, and I is assigned the value totrose, that means we have searched through all the data and we haven't found anything, then we need to give out a message. So message box, name not found. And end if. Intuitively, I thought about this code. So let's run this and see what happens. So we save it. We click on the run button. Clear this. And let's say we look for Harry Jones, and I forget the S. So when I search, it tells me name not found, which is perfect. So if I make this now Harry Jones, correct it, and I search for it, I should get Harry's grade and the marks. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.